In the nation's first ruling of its kind, a Jackson County judge finds Bishop Robert Finn guilty of failing to report suspicions of child abuse.
I truly regret and am sorry for the hurt that these events have caused. I thank you for the opportunity to address.
The judge found Bishop Finn guilty of a misdemeanor. The charge stemmed from former priest Sean Radigan producing child pornography, and the diocese waiting several months to report him to police. The judge ruled Finn will serve 2 years probation and must follow several conditions, including mandated reporter training to recognize the signs of child abuse and pornography. It's such a historic ruling. Many wonder what now happens to the man in charge of the local Catholic diocese. KBC9's Cliff Judy joins us live from the downtown courthouse. Cliff?
And Len, I was in the courtroom this afternoon. It was a standing room only crowd. There were so many emotions on both sides of this case. With this case ending, here's what we found about the future of Bishop Robert Finn in Kansas City and St. Joseph.
I truly regret Sorry.
Reading a brief statement to the court, Bishop Robert Finn acknowledged his own failings just moments after the judge handed down a guilty verdict.
I think these recommended conditions of probation are appropriate.
The first ever bishop in the U.S. convicted of protecting an abusive priest.
He never intentionally did anything wrong or would cover anything up. I know that's not of his character.
Intent or not, he failed. And it's not about being Catholic. It's about an organization that had a man in charge that failed.
Both emotions came out after Thursday's bench trial. Since prosecutors charged Bishop Finn with failing to report suspicions of child abuse by former priest Sean Radigan, local Catholics rallied both to support Finn and to call the Vatican to remove him. That question remains. Bria Roper attended Thursday's trial to pray for the bishop.
I really appreciate him as a person and as a bishop and as my shepherd. So I'll continue to pray for him and continue to support him.
This is just my opinion, but I believe that if it was outside of the Catholic Church, any other organization, that he would have been asked to step down or forced to step down.
We asked the diocese about Bishop Finn's future and whether he'll stay in Kansas City. A spokesman responded, "The bishop looks forward to continuing to perform his duties, including carrying out the important obligations placed on him by the court." Some reporters even posed the question of Finn's future to prosecutors at a post-trial press conference.
Whether or not he remains in a leadership position, again, that you'll have to call Rome to get that answer.
Now, this means that the criminal case against Bishop Finn and the diocese is finished. Because the judge came down with a guilty verdict against Bishop Finn, the diocese, the prosecutors basically decided to dismiss the charges against the diocese. I asked prosecutors, why did you make that deal? They said in a case like this, there's give and take, and they felt that Bishop Finn was the most responsible party in this case. Len?
All right. Thank you, Cliff. Prosecutors also pointed out today's bench trial meant they did not have to put child victims on the stand, something their parents wanted to avoid.